This is about the clinical features, smallpox. It was eradicated in 1980. The clinical features are fever, headache, back pain, and third day centrifugal rash. Third day of the fever, there will be centrifugal rash. So it will be distributed more towards the extremities. But in chickenpox, it is a centripetal. It is a vesicular rash. Herpes zoster may be latent infection. Rapid evolution, and it will be pleomorphic, which is, it contains all the stages of the rash, that is MP, VP, scab, we say, that is macule, papule, vesicle, pustule and scab. So all the phases will be present in pleomorphic, it will be a landmark for chickenpox. So it will be deep seated rash. For measles, it is consist of three stages, that is prodromal stage and eruptive stage and post measles stage. Prodromal stage, it is fever, coryza, cough, coplic spots will be diagnostic. Eruptive spot, eruptive phase, that is typical dusky maculopapular rash from ears, it starts from ears to the face to the lower extremities. And the post measles phase, which will be a deprived phase with malnutrition. Rubella, 50% of the infections will go asymptomatic. Then here the stages, there will be prodromal, then a stage with lymphadenopathy and maculopapular rash. This prodromal phase is associated with fever, sore throat and coryza. For congenital rubella, it is deafness, cardiac malformations and cataracts, that is the triad of congenital rubella. So when it affects the pregnant mothers, mumps 30 to 40% will be asymptomatic. It will be associated with parotiditis. Mumps complications are very important, then it will be dealt with in the next slide. Influenza, chills, malaise, fever, muscular pains and cough will be the symptoms. This is the flu symptoms, we say together, all this together. Diphtheria, presents with anterior nasal, false shell and laryngeal, and the false membrane present in around the throat, especially around the tonsil, will create this toxin and it will cause the toxemia. Whooping cough, fever and irritating cough will be present, which will be followed by a catarrhal stage and paroxysmal stage and the convalescent stage. There will be, in meningococcal meningitis, there will be headache, vomiting and stiff neck, and it is 50% fatal and if untreated. And we all know the incubation period is also short and 50% fatal if untreated. So sudden death will be caused in meningococcal meningitis. ARI, classification of illness is based on the fast breathing, chest indrawing, it is depending upon the age, again, stride, presence of the strider, wheeze, fever, drowsiness and severe malnutrition categorizes into severe disease. SARS, it will be similar to the influenza, fever, malaise, chills, headache, myalgia, cough and running nose will be there. Tuberculosis, cough, fever, chest pain are the cardinal symptoms of tuberculosis. Intestinal diseases, the clinical features, polio will be, as we told earlier, polio is a gastrointestinal transmitted disease but presenting with CNS manifestations. So most of the infections will go subclinical, some will go abortive minor illness, some will go as a non-paralytic CNS manifestations. Only 1% of the cases will cause paralysis and death. Viral hepatitis, it causes jaundice, GA symptoms. A is usually self-limiting. B is 1% fatal. The hepatocellular carcinoma is also there. E will cause fulminant hepatitis. That too particularly along with the pregnancy. D is dangerous when it is present co-infection with the hepatitis B. Acute diarrheal disease. Acute watery, the most common cause is Vibrio cholerae, E. coli. Acute bloody diarrhea, the most common cause is Shigella. Persistent diarrhea, when the diarrhea is more than 14 days. Diarrhea with severe malnutrition. So, diarrhea is classified into four types. Cholera, there are three stages. Stages of evacuation, stage of collapse and stage of recovery. Typhoid, stepladder fever is a characteristic pattern. And the stepladder fever, bradycardia and headache are the triad of typhoid fever. Enteric fever, when it is associated with Salmonella paratyphi, it is 1% fatal. Piece of diarrhea will be present. Rose spot is pathognomic of typhoid fever. Food poisoning, Salmonella is the common type associated with fever. This is the only type which is associated with fever. Vomiting and diarrhea will be common in poisoning cases. It is about 1%, it is fatal. Staphylococcus, it is a heat stable toxin. Even with heating, we cannot eliminate this. It is always associated with abdominal cramps, but it is not fatal. Botulism is a heat liable toxin. Even with heating, it is just going to get destroyed. It affects the parasympathetic nervous system and death is most common if left untreated. So Clostridium, it has no fever, no death, but it affects with less duration. Bacillus cereus, it has both emetic and diarrheal form, where the vomiting and diarrhea will be predominant. And Staphylococcus, there will not be any death in Bacillus cereus. Amoebiasis, only 10% of the cases will be symptomatic. Intestinal symptoms will be there and extra intestinal symptoms will be there. Ascariasis, nausea, abdominal pain, cough, diarrhea, weakness will be present. Same symptoms will be there in Pucom infection also. So dengue syndrome, we have fever, hemorrhage and hemorrhage with shock as a different grades of dengue fever. Malaria, we have stages as cold stage, hot stage and sweating stage, which is associated with fever, chills and rigors. The lymphatic filariasis infects the lymphatic system. Disabling disease, occult filariasis also will be there. Zika virus, it appears with fever, rash and malaise and myalgia, headache. Rabies, it is almost 100% fatal. Only 3 cases in history have recovered from the disease. Prodromal stage will be there. Excitation and stimulation will be there. There will be aerophobia, that is fear of air, and fear of hydrophobia, fear of water will be present. Yellow fever presents with a hemorrhagic fever leading to the death. Nipah fever, asymptomatic cases will be there, like an acute respiratory infection, to fatal encephalitis. Encephalitis is a common cause of death in Nipah virus infection. About 40 to 50% cases will be fatal. Japanese encephalitis, over to subclinical case ratio is about 1:250. Prodromal stage will be there, encephalitis stage will be there, late stage and sequelae will be present. KFD will present with fever, headache, myalgia, hemorrhages and CNS manifestations are the causes of mortality in KFD. Chikungunya fever never causes death, but fever, chills, joint pains and arthropathy will be there. Brucellosis, fever, arthritis will be present. Splenomegaly, in animals it causes abortion. Leptospirosis, fever, liver and kidney failure, there will be ictric and anictric type. Plague, there will be bubonic plague, septicemic presentation and pneumonic presentation, and then this pneumonic case is infective type. Human salmonellosis, enteric fever, but presents with enteric fever, gastroenteritis and septicemia. Teniasis, it presents with the cysticercae, it will not present with any symptoms, and when there is a pressure effects, especially in the abdomen and in brain, it will be serious. Hydatid disease, cysts in lungs, liver, brain, bones, peritoneum and kidney. Leishmaniasis, Kala-Azar, otherwise called as visceral leishmaniasis, which is 95% fatal if untreated. It is associated with fever, anemia, hepatosplenomegaly and darkening of skin of the face. Cutaneous leishmaniasis, which is common, usually mistaken for leprosy. Rickettsial zoonosis, fever, headache, prostration, malaise, skin rash and hepatosplenomegaly will be presenting symptoms. And all these symptoms will be very common except for the absence of skin lesions in Q fever. Q fever more often presents with similarity to influenza. In scrub typhus, it always resembles epidemic typhus. SR is a classical pathognomic feature of scrub typhus. Murine typhus is similar to Louisbourn typhus, but it is always milder. Trachoma presents with blinding and non-blinding type, causing entropion, trichiasis and corneal ulcers. It is a common cause of blindness in developing countries. It is one of the common causes of blindness in developing countries. Tetanus, it is associated with painful paroxysmal spasms of the voluntary muscles. Neonatal tetanus is 80 to 90% fatal. The presence of the exotoxin, it is due to the exotoxin. Traumatic, purpural, autogenic, idiopathic and neonatal tetanus are the types of tetanus. Leprosy, lepromatous, tuberculoid forms will be there. Cardinal symptoms will be hypopigmented patches, loss of cutaneous sensation, thickened nerves, acid fast bacillus in skin or nasal smears. There are many classifications like Madrid classification, Indian classification and bacteriological classification, and the treatment will be based on the bacteriological classification, again possibacillary and multibacillary. STD, the clinical features will be given the treatment, usually the discharge, urethral discharge, vaginal discharge, lower abdominal pain, crotal swelling, inguinal bubose. Yaas will present as early yaas and late yaas. AIDS will present as initial infection, asymptomatic carrier state, then AIDS related complex and AIDS. here there will not be any opportunistic, here the immune system is compromised, but there will not be any opportunistic infection or cancer. So that is the major difference. So in complications, usually chickenpox is self-limiting. The complications may be hemorrhages, pneumonia. So most of the times, how can we remember these complications is, see, intestinal diseases, most commonly the complications will be due to dehydration. Here the complications will be due to pneumonia or septicemia or multi-organ failure. So here hemorrhages, pneumonia, encephalitis, acute cerebral ataxia, Reye syndrome, maternal varicella, secondary bacterial infections. Measles, it presents, complications will be otitis media, croup, diarrhea and pneumonia, encephalitis and SSPE, that is subsclerosing panencephalitis, rubella, arthralgia, thrombocytopenic purpura, mumps, orchitis, ovaritis, pancreatitis are the most common complications. Meningoencephalitis will be there, thyroiditis, neuritis, hepatitis, myocarditis, influenza pneumonia is a common complication and cause of the death, diphtheria, toxic damage in the heart, liver, kidney and adrenal glands, whooping cough, bronchitis, bronchopneumonia, bronchiectasis and hemorrhages, meningococcal septicemia for meningococcal meningitis, ARI, the pneumonia is the common complication and cause of the death, SARS, pneumonia, pulmonary decompensation, ARDS, acute respiratory distress syndrome is the most common cause of the death. Here in complications for typhoid, hemorrhage is the most common cause. Perforation is cause of complication of typhoid fever. Amoebiasis, which can be lethal due to the complications. Ascariasis, volvulus, obstruction, into susception, perforation may be present. Hookworm infection, because of the bleeding, iron deficiency, anemia may be present. Dengue syndrome, the most common complication is hemorrhage and shock. Malaria, organ failures are the complications leading to death. And in Nipah virus infection, encephalitis and respiratory illness, residual neurological consequences are the complications of the disease. Leptospirosis, liver and kidney damage and hemorrhage. Q fever, pneumonia is the complication. For leprosy, complications will be lepra reactions and the deformities, which is present in the extremities and in the face. For laboratory diagnosis, chickenpox, it will be usually clinical. DNA PCR, isolation, direct immunofluorescence. Measles, IgM, ELISA, RNA, RT-PCR. Rubella, virus isolation and serology, heme inhibition, ELISA. For influenza, it is virus isolation and antigen, serology, ELISA and RT-PCR. Diphtheria, nose and throat swab culture. For whooping cough, bacteriological examinations of nasopharyngeal swabs and fluorescent antibody technique. Tuberculosis, sputum AFB, chest X-ray, CBNAT are needed according to the current algorithm by RNTCP. Viral hepatitis, abnormal LFT will be there. For A, ELISA, IgM, anti-HAV, HAV antigen. For B, HBsAg, antibody, HBs antibody. And C, it is RIBA, HCV RNA testing. E, antibody for IgG and IgM, RT-PCR. D, antibody for IgG and IgM, RNA assays. For ADD, mild and severe dehydration, signs from head to toe will diagnose ADD. Cholera, direct examination of the samples, culture, characterization and biochemical tests. Typhoid fever, isolation and culture, serology, IDL, tubex and typhoid. Amoebiasis, the presence of the cyst in the stool and the tropocyte in the RBC is diagnostic of amoebiasis. Dengue syndrome, virus isolation, viral NA detection, antigen, antibody. Malaria, RDT microscopy. Lymphatic filariasis, mass blood survey, thick film, DEC provocation test. Zika virus, PCR and virus isolation. Rabies, based on the history and the clinical presentation and immunofluorescence. Nipah virus, RT-PCR, ELISA. Japanese encephalitis, IgM, ELISA in the blood and CSF. KFD virus and isolation and serology. Chikungunya, ELISA, RT-PCR for IgM. Leptospirosis, culture identification and ELISA. Plague staining culture and serology. Pyrated disease, radiological, serological through ELISA. leishmaniasis through the RK39 rapid diagnostic test with visceral leishmaniasis antigen, aldehyde test, serology and leishmanin test, rickettsial zoonosis isolation, serology, immunofluorescent assay, ELISA. For murine typhus, Weill Felix with OX19 positive. Trachoma, clinical diagnosis, two of the four criteria, follicles in upper tarsal conjunctiva, Herbert Spitz, typical conjunctival scarring and vascular pannus. Leprosy, clinical bacterial examination and lepromin test. So based on which multibacillary and possibacillary will be categorized and the treatment will be initiated based on that. AIDS, two major and one minor criteria is there. Western blot is a specific test for used for confirmation. ELISA is a sensitive test used for screening test. So how to prevent these diseases? Chickenpox, which will be varicella zoster immunoglobulin within the 72 hours of exposure, 12.5 units per kilogram, 625 units maximum. Live vaccine, 0.5 ml subcutaneous, 2 doses which is 6 weeks apart. Along with MMR, varicella is also given as MMRV in 9th month and 12, anywhere between 9 months to 12 years, 2 doses 4 weeks apart. Measles vaccine is included in national immunization schedule. And measles immunoglobulin 0.25 ml per kilogram within 3 to 4 days of exposure. For rubella, RA vaccine 27/3, 1 dose 0.5 ml subcutaneous. For mumps, live vaccine with gerial line strain 0.5 ml IM. Influenza, how to prevent this is by good ventilation, respiratory hygiene, hand washing and restriction of movement outside. So all these things can be applied for all the respiratory infections. Vaccination 2 weeks before the epidemic is needed. Killed vaccines, 2 doses are available 4 weeks apart, 0.5 ml subcutaneous or IM. Live vaccines are intranasal spray, which is a single dose which is also present. Zanamivir, oseltamivir for prophylaxis can be given. Diphtheria along with Pentavax 6/10/14 0.5 ml IM is in the national immunization schedule. Whooping cough also is present within Pentavax. Meningococcal meningitis, there is a quadrivalent polysaccharide vaccine containing ACW135Y subtypes. Measles vaccine, Hib vaccine, pneumococcal pneumonia vaccine for ARI. SARS, there is no vaccine. Isolation is the best treatment. Respiratory hygiene, hand washing will prevent the disease. Tuberculosis, BCG vaccination and isoniazid hemoprophylaxis. Poliomyelitis, polio surveillance, OPV and fractional IPV. For viral hepatitis, 2 dose inactivated vaccine 6 months apart for greater than 12 years. Live 1 dose which is subcutaneous, immunoglobulin can be given. And for B, hepatitis B vaccine and Pentavax also contains this hepatitis B. And hepatitis B vaccine is given immediately after birth, immunoglobulin can be given. For prevention of ADD, rotavirus, 2 live oral attenuated dosed vaccine is available. Cholera, there are 3 types of oral vaccines, Ducoral, Shancol, M or Quax, Uvicol will be available. Typhoid fever, VI polysaccharide subunit, subcutaneous or IM, 1 dose every 3 year. Type 21 vaccine, oral 3 doses on 1, 3 and 4 days every 3 years. For amoebiasis, sanitation, water supply, food hygiene, health education can prevent the disease. Hookworm infection, insisting on the footwears, deworming and prevention of open air defecation will prevent the disease. Dragonculiasis aimed at the abolition of stepwells and the control of vector. Here in arthropod disease, the best way is vector control, that too by the environmental control and the anti-adult and larval measures, vector control and chemoprophylaxis. Lymphatic filariasis, DEC chemoprophylaxis and vector control. Zika virus, again vector control. Rabies virus, vaccination and treatment of the wound. The first aid of the care of the wound created by the dog bite or the animal bite. Yellow fever, 17D vaccine. Vector control, that is Aedes aegypti index, which is maintained around the airports. Japanese encephalitis, JE vaccine, which is given in the endemic districts of India. Vector control, killed KFD vaccine. For KFD, tick control and personal protective equipments. For chikungunya fever, vector control and PPE. Brucellosis, test and slaughter. will prevent the brucellosis affected animals from getting slaughtered. Vaccination, pasteurization and protection. Leptospirosis can be prevented by environmental measures. Plague can be prevented by flea and rodent control, vaccine, tetracycline prophylaxis, QID for 5 days. Teniasis can be prevented by proper sanitation and careful slaughtering. Hydatid disease by sanitation and hygiene. Leishmaniasis, man is the only reservoir. So, sandfly control, personal protection will prevent the disease. Scrub typhus, murine typhus can be prevented by vector control and mitocial chemicals. Q fever, pasteurization. Trachoma, safe strategy, that is S for surgery, A for antibiotic, F for facial hygiene, E for environmental sanitation. Tetanus, maternal and neonatal tetanus are preventable. Injection, TT, active immunization and passive immunization with 0.01 international units of ml of antitoxin. DPT, TT immunoglobulin and all are targeted at preventing tetanus. Leprosy mass treatment can be given. AIDS, STD control, health education, ART and promotion of safe sex will prevent the disease. Now we are in the last segment, that is the treatment. Treatment for individual diseases, that is chickenpox, acyclovir is the commonly used drug. Measles, supportive care, nutrition, isolation and vitamin A, there is no specific drug. Influenza, asymptomatic care, zanamivir and oseltamivir are the most commonly used. Diphtheria antitoxin, 22,000 units, IM or IV, penicillin or erythromycin. For 5 to 6 days is the drug of choice. Whooping cough, erythromycin 30 to 50 mg per kilogram per day in 4 divided doses for 10 days. Meningococcal meningitis, penicillin is the first choice or the ceftriaxone. For acute respiratory infection, cotrimaxazole when pneumonia is present, severe pneumonia is present, then we have to go for benzylpenicillin, ampicillin, chloramphenicol. SARS intensive support should be given, ribavirin, lopinavir, interferon 1, IV immunoglobulin, steroids have a role in treatment of SARS. Tuberculosis, we have first line drugs as HRSTS. For viral hepatitis, only hepatitis C requires direct antiviral agents. Acute diarrheal diseases, ORS is the treatment, 75 ml per kilogram during the first 4 hours. IV, if the child is less than 130 ml per kilogram in 1 hour and 70 ml per kilogram in 5 hours. If it is greater than 1 year, then it is half of the duration. So that is less than 1 year means we need to give 30 ml per kilogram in half an hour and 70 ml per kilogram in 2.5 hours. And antibiotics have a role. Zinc has a role in prevention of further episodes of diarrhea. Cholera, the treatment of choice is fluoroquinolones, tetracycline, azithromycin, ampicillin, cotrimaxazole can be used. Typhoid fever, chloramphenicol is the first choice, followed by the list of this drug. Amoebiasis, metronidazole is the drug of choice, 30 mg per kilogram in 3 doses for 8 to 10 days. Hookworm infection, albendazole, mebendazole, levimazole, pyrantel are the drugs used in treatment of the hookworm infection. Dragonculosis, there is no specific treatment. Removal of the worm from the site, metronidazole has a role, mebendazole also may help. Dengue syndrome, ORS plays an important role, followed by paracetamol, IV fluids. For hemorrhage and shock, IV fluids and blood will be useful. Malaria, ovale, so O, that is ovale and vivax should be treated similarly with chloroquine 25 mg per kilogram, primaquine 0.25 mg per kilogram for 14 days. Falciparum will be treated as malaria. IACT and primaquine should be given, that is artemisinin combination therapy should be given, and artemisinin combination primaquine in northeastern states. So lymphatic filariasis, analgesics, antibiotics and care of the lesion should be given as the treatment. Zika virus, rest fluids, analgesics and antibiotics are the treatment of the choice. For yellow fever, supportive care and antibiotics are the treatment. There is no specific drugs. For Japanese encephalitis, there is AES management, that is acute encephalitis syndrome protocol is there. Chikungunya fever, supportive care should be given. Brucellosis, tetracycline, 500 mg QID for 3 weeks is the treatment of choice. Leptospirosis, penicillin, 6 million unit daily IV should be given. Teniasis, praziquintal, 10 mg per kilogram, 1 dose, or niclosamide, 2 gram single dose should be given. Surgery should be done if there is a pressure within the brain, within the skull or within the abdomen. Treatment of the cysticercosis, praziquintal and albendazole can be useful. Hydatid disease, surgery is the treatment of choice. Mebendazole also plays a role. Leishmaniasis, single dose, liposomal amphotericin B, IV, 10 mg per kilogram is the drug of choice. Miltefosine, paromomycin are helpful. Rickettsial zoonosis, scrub typhus, murine typhus, tetracycline are the drug of choice. Q fever, doxycycline is the drug of choice. trachoma, 1% tetracycline ointment locally to be given, and surgical correction of the deformities like entropion should be done. Tetanus, benzathine penicillin, 1.2 million units is a drug of choice. Anti-tetanus serum should be given in order to neutralize the toxin produced. Leprosy, for multibacillary, it is rifampicin, dapsone and clofazamine. For paucibacillary, it is rifampicin and dapsone. STD syndromic approach is there. There are various color-coded tablets for this different set of symptoms. That is urethral discharge, vaginal discharge, abdominal pain, genital discharge, scrotal swelling, inguinal bubose. YAS through azithromycin will be helpful. Benzathine penicillin G will be helpful. For AIDS, it is nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitors, non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, protease inhibitors, integrase strand transverse inhibitors. So whatever the drug which end with the vir will be protease inhibitors, except for tenofovir, which is a nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor, and also abacavir, which falls here. The other woodine group of drugs, iron group of drugs, zidovudine, stavovudine and all, will fall under nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. Efavirenz, etravirine, nevirapine are non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. So here are some of the questions which have been asked as a short notes. Prevention of neonatal tetanus, natural history of measles, strategies of polio eradication in India, syndromic approach in STDs, congenital rubella syndrome, acute encephalitis syndrome, diarrheal diseases, diphtheria, food poisoning, leprosy, leptospirosis, control of scabies, scrub typhus, BCG vaccination, yellow fever vaccine, nosocomial infections, oral polio vaccine, universal precautions to prevent HIV vaccines, radical treatment of malaria, national pulse polio immunization program, acute flaccid paralysis, influenza vaccines, dengue fever, vaccine vial monitor, typhoid carriers, oral dehydration therapy, and so on. So these are all some of the short answers which was asked as a 2-marker. Rehabilitation, passive surveillance in tuberculosis, channelless index, that is WHOCOM infection, that is number of eggs present in 1 gram of feces, annual parasitic index, DEDC provocation, this contract tracing and all. So individual questions can be focused and read before your exams. I will try to make one more short video on mnemonics in community medicine part 2. Till then, subscribe and click on the bell icon. Thank you very much for watching.